minority leader then, we did not subject the removal of the deputy speaker, or for that matter, the speaker, or any person to this act. That I must say on record. Number two, for the avoidance of doubt, Mr. Speaker, I think for the reasons why, when you look at the Constitution, Article 106, and the standing orders, where this is a special motion, the reason why I think, and it's my opinion, there are no reasons, is because the position and the motion we are moving is of a member who continues sitting in this House after the motion. And therefore, Mr. Speaker, it is important that that person who is going to continue sitting, who is holding a position, continues sitting in this House after a motion of this nature has been moved. And that is the position of a deputy speaker. Thirdly, Mr. Speaker, it's not a coincidence that this motion is being moved by the leaders. We are warning ourselves, me included, that the seat I occupy as minority whip, that seat belongs to the coalition. And I must, in all cases, in the trust bestowed upon me by that coalition, continue advocating for the obligations, rights, and wishes of that coalition. Once that trust is done, Mr. Speaker, there is nothing this House can do to a person who has lost trust of his political party. It sounds like a death knell, but it's a fact. The premium, Mr. Speaker, for these positions we occupy is loyalty to the cause. Unfortunately, Mr. Speaker, our friend, Professor Kindiki, finds himself in this position. Mr. Speaker, it's not also a coincidence that Article 106 puts such a high threshold. And I want to mention that as I sit, because I will not get into the details that Senator Kang'ata did, because a lot of us are not party to those issues. And I strongly believe those are not issues that all of us ought to get into. Professor Kithure Kindiki, and any person occupying that position under Article 106, Mr. Speaker, must be able to show that he has the confidence of the House. And that is the reason there's a two-thirds membership. And that membership, Mr. Speaker, is a membership of the majority and minority. It's a simple thing. Votes of confidence all over the world, Mr. Speaker, are not personal. So nobody carries a personal agenda against Professor Kindiki. None of us, Mr. Speaker, are questioning his competence. None of us, Mr. Speaker, including myself, is conducting a trial. I would have great difficulties if we were conducting a trial. Since we are not conducting a trial, we did not conduct any recruitment of either you, the Speaker, or the Deputy Speaker, Mr. Speaker. You are elected politically. You are brought here politically. You persuaded the majority to elect you politically, and therefore you must persuade the majority to continue remaining in office politically. There's no other question. There's no middle ground, and that is the end of it. Mr. Speaker, to say that this is momentous, it is. We have rarely had a motion of this nature, or even passed any constitutional motion that requires two-thirds. The fact that this motion has reached this far should tick the mind of Professor Kindiki. What is it that you have done to this membership that would cause so many of them to allow this motion to reach at this stage? Now I'm talking to your conscience, because these decisions are about your conscience. It's not omissions or commissions. It's confidence in this House. You will sit with us here after this motion, whether you're removed or not. But ask yourself these questions as you go along. The overtures you are offered, Senator Kindiki, should have informed your decision. Since you didn't take them, the vote of confidence will be taken, and you will see it for yourself what it means, Mr. Speaker, to have a motion of this nature. Therefore, allow me to quote Churchill, because this is politics, and politics has no form. And this is what he had to say, and I say this to Professor Kindiki, my friend. Politics is the ability to foretell what is going to happen tomorrow, next week, next month, and next year, and to have the ability to explain why it didn't happen. You know what has befell you, Professor Kindiki. I support the motion. Thank you.
Honorable senators.
Sorry, I second.
Honorable senators, I now propose the question, which is that the Senate resolves that Senator Professor Kithure Kindiki, EGH MP, be removed from the office of the Deputy Speaker of the Senate. Senator Cherargei. Please come. What's your point of order, Senator Ross?
Mr. Speaker, I think this debate may raise a lot of interest, and I'm just wondering if there is a time limit on the debate, Mr. Speaker.
How do people?
Mr. Speaker, how do I make my interest known to you if I want to contribute, Mr. Speaker, to the motion? Is it by pressing?
Yeah, you press. You'll press, then I'll not on my paper.
When we press, Mr. Speaker, the mic comes. It doesn't
hear. Yeah, it comes. I'll not.
Okay.
3 minutes. Except the leaders. I'll give the leaders 5 minutes each. Senator Cherargei.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir, for this opportunity. I've had my brother, Senator Kang'ata, who is a State House appointee of the majority side, saying that our brother, Senator, Deputy Speaker,
point
Senator.
What's your point of order, Senator? Steward Mazayo.
Yes. Asante Bwana Speaker. Bwana Speaker, umetuambia katika uamuzi wako ya kwamba tusitumie maneno ambayo yatakuwa aidha yanadharau ama yanaweza kuudhi mtu. Na mimi ninavyoelewa ni kwamba tafadhali Murkomen, kama mimi naongea, it's only fair if you keep quiet. I'm on a point of order. Bwana Speaker, taratibu ni kwamba na tunavyoelewa Senator Kang'ata ni senator wa Murang'a. Lakini sasa tukiambiwa kwamba Senator Kang'ata ni either ni mfanyikazi ama ni mtumishi wa State House, hiyo sisi hatuelewi. Kama ni hivyo, basi ni mtu ambaye hatakani kuketi hapa. Kama anaketi State House, amekuja kufanya nini ndani ya bunge la Senate? Na alichaguliwa na watu wa Murang'a. Kwa hiyo mimi nauliza tu, je, ni sawa sawa ikiwa ndugu yangu, mdogo wangu ambaye ni rafiki yangu, Cherargei, anaweza kutumia lugha kama hiyo?
Sio sawa sawa. Nataka niulize, I want to appeal your honorable members, please don't force me into, you know, taking action that I should not take. You can still communicate, you can convey your message without necessarily getting into all those unnecessary jargon and whatever. Senator Cherargei.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I think he misunderstood me, and I can see Senator Kang'ata is excited because it knows the weight of being referred as a State House appointee, because as a majority leader, we never sat to elect him. So I'm told it was through chai and mandazization that is.
Senator Cherargei, order, Senator. No. Senator Cherargei, please. Yes. You are out of order. Please, you are out of order. Let's not get into those. Please. Make your point, please.
But Mr. Speaker, you need also to protect me because I can see people.
No, but I'm protecting you. That's why.
Mr. Speaker, you should allow me to be listened to. I can see people shouting across the aisle, especially people.
Make your point, Senator Cherargei.
In the next few minutes, I want to say this. One is that I oppose this motion because it is illegal, it is immoral, it is even ungodly. Professor Kithure Kindiki not only has distinguished himself as a legal scholar, but has ably made rulings that have been even referred by other jurisdictions. Professor Kindiki, having served as the majority leader of then TNA and URB, and now as the deputy speaker of this house, has done very well. This political conmanship and persecution and scheming that continues, Mr. President, Mr. Speaker, across the political majority.
That's a point of order, Senator.
Mr. Speaker, we are all being listened to. And Mr. Speaker, you have heard Cherargei say that we are discussing political conmanship, an illegal and immoral motion. Mr. Speaker, if we allow one member to talk like that, would I be in order to also say that you will expand the debate and we talk about others' immorality? Would it be okay if we engage in such verbiage? Mr. Speaker, I request that you enforce your ruling that we be of decorum, because if the other side starts or some people start talking the way they are doing, we have some very hot-blooded members on either side, and this thing is going to be nasty, and it's going to be shameful to the House.
Senator Cherargei, I want to caution you for the last time that there are statements that you can make in political rallies, funerals, or other places. This is a house of respect and integrity. Please make your point and stick to language that is parliamentary. I'm asking you.
Mr. Speaker, what I was just simply saying is that this moral does not meet even the threshold of principles of natural justice. Professor Kindiki, despite the fact that they are leveling accusations, I have heard even, it is shocking even to this country, that the state of Senator Kang'ata can challenge your rulings. It doesn't mean who sits in that seat. Even speaker panelists who sit there and make rulings, they are sanctified. Those rulings are very serious. So it has exposed to country that there is a specific way of ensuring that they persecute individuals based on political affiliation or inclination for the expediency. And I want to say this, Mr. Speaker, sir, that if this House makes either reason, either to retain or remove Professor Kithure Kindiki, it will determine the future of this House as a Senate and as Parliament. And if today Professor Kithure Kindiki is being prosecuted and removed as the Deputy Speaker of the Senate of the Republic of Kenya, Mr. Speaker, sir, if it goes ahead and we remove him, then we will lack both moral and legal and legislative roles that we have had as a House. Mr. Speaker, it's so disappointing that people, even I chair the legal, courtesy of the majority side, but that one is not a privilege, it is a right. Why do we make it that members who sit in leadership position appear that it's the privilege and prerogative of the party? It is not. And that is why as Jubilee will not allow impunity, worship of demigods within the party to continue, Mr. Speaker, sir.
What's your point of order, Senator Khaniri?
Mr. Speaker, I want you to make a ruling on this because I know for sure that all motions that come on the floor of this House are approved by the Speaker of the House. The Honorable Senator Fonandi has made an allegation that the motion being debated now is illegal and immoral. Mr. Speaker, if we leave this on the record of this House, then it will mean that the Speaker of the Senate approved an illegal and immoral motion and presided over the same. Mr. Speaker, I think it is absolutely important that the member withdraws those words so that they expunge from our records. Secondly, Mr. Speaker, I want to state clearly that we are not discussing the qualifications, the integrity of my age mate, Senator Kithure Kindiki.
We have been told clearly that Kindiki was sponsored to this position by a party called Jubilee because they had confidence in him. They have since lost confidence in him, the sponsoring party. We are not debating his integrity, his capabilities. We are not. We are saying the party that sponsored him says that they have lost confidence in him. So is he in order to start debating Senator Professor Kithure Kindiki's integrity?
Senator Cherargei, I want to appeal to you that irrespective of what your emotions are, please remember that what some of the things you're saying are really border on challenging the office of the speaker. So can you wind up and so that we are able to move?
Mr. Speaker, sir, I think I clarified that this motion in itself, I think my good neighbor was not listening, is that does not even adhere to principles of natural justice. Finally, Mr. Speaker, on the issue of confidence of the party, I can confirm to this House and Kenyans and 8 million plus Jubilee members across the country that we have never, as the senators of majority, either sat either virtually through Zoom meeting or any other form or in person to endorse any changes that we have lost confidence in Professor Kithure Kindiki as deputy Speaker of the Senate, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, as a party, we will not allow some of us who are in Jubilee that these issues of impunity and political witch hunt should be prosecuted in a specific way. And therefore, Mr. Speaker, I want to challenge my colleagues. I can see across the aisle that this decision is not about the individualism. This decision is about the future of this House. You know, this House is facing a lot of dangers, Mr. Speaker. And I can confirm to you, if we allow this impunity to go on and use rubber stamp as the minority side, if this continues to happen, Mr. Speaker, I can confirm to you that it is not going to stop here. You will be giving license to the party owners from wherever you come so that they can continue purging you politically. And for us, we are saying, Aluta, continue. I oppose this motion in loudest terms possible. I thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Senator Chilayako.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.